covering the Palm Beaches and the Treasure Coast. This is WPBF 25 News, first at 4.
To have something like this happen to me and nobody do anything about it, it hurts.
A Treasure Coast man says someone is out to ruin him by passing around flyers calling him a sexual predator. Thank you for staying with us. I'm Tiffany Kenny. Felicia Rodriguez is off today. This is an update to an exclusive story we first brought you yesterday. Meredith McDonough has live coverage from Port St. Lucie, where Alan Schmigdahl says that he is the target of a hate crime. Meredith?
Tiffany, these flyers are creating quite a stir here in this Port St. Lucie neighborhood. And now residents are standing up for their neighbor who was attacked in these flyers.
Most neighbors are positive for me. They're supportive of me.
You first met Alan Schmigdahl Tuesday. He lives along Bermel Avenue in Port St. Lucie, and his neighbors are standing up in his defense. Last week, these flyers were found in mailboxes along the street, calling Alan a child predator. The flyers say that Alan rides his bike around wooing young boys, and that Halloween is coming up, and to watch your children from this pervert. The flyers have his name, address, and sexual orientation. His neighbor Shira says she's seen enough.
I would totally trust him to watch my kids. I would totally he's watched my house. Mm-hmm. He's got a heart of gold, and my kids love him. I'm going on Facebook with my friends and letting them know that this is going on, and if you do receive something, please do not believe it.
We contacted Port St. Lucie police to check out these allegations made against Alan.
I've checked my in-house records, and there's nothing identify that he's a sexual predator. I've also checked the FDLA website. Also, nothing identifying him as a sexual predator. And I also checked his criminal history. He's never been arrested, therefore, he's never been convicted of a sex crime, nor been arrested for a sex crime.
Once Alan's neighbor, Tony, learned the claims were false, she made her own flyers, setting the story straight. And since our story aired Tuesday, more neighbors are reaching out in support.
Everybody's been calling and talking and saying that they really feel bad for him. And, you know, so, I mean, actually, he made a lot of good friends in the neighborhood now, so.
We spoke with a postal inspector by phone who says people forget it is illegal to place items inside of mailboxes.
Mail receptacle for the U.S. Post Office, and only items bearing postage on it can be placed inside or outside of the mailbox. We're in the preliminary stages. We just received the information not too long ago, and we're looking into it.
It hurts inside. That's all I have to say, and I hope I don't have to pick up and move someday because of this, because, you know, this person, whoever's doing this to me, they're destroying me, you know.
And for the person responsible to come forward. Now, Alan did go to police, and they told him that this is a civil matter, not a criminal matter. And since then, he has contacted an attorney and plans to move forward. We are live in Port St. Lucie. Meredith McDonough, WPBF 25 News.